Hey guys, today I'm going to show you how to replace the screw in your solar screw pump. Now for this we're going to need a 10mm socket, Phillips head screwdriver, a 13mm and a 14mm spanner, and a 3mm Allen key. You're also going to need a spare screw to replace it with. Each kit comes with one by default. If you need spares, check out our website. The screw or helical rotor is the part of the pump that actually pushes the water. Over time, it will eventually wear down. You'll notice this when you're moving significantly less water. In higher pressure systems, you'll notice this a lot quicker. Step one. First, make sure your pump is off and completely disconnected from the power source. Step two. You can now lift it out of the reservoir. This must be done by lifting with a chain, rope, or cable that is attached to the dedicated fixture points on the pump. Do not at any point pull on the power cable. This can permanently damage the pump. Step three. So now that you've pulled the pump out of the water, you can take off the top of it by unscrewing the top four bolts with a 10mm socket set. Now that you've undone those bolts, we can take the top plate off. Step four. Now we're going to take off the cable housing and the metal grate here. You're going to need a Phillips head screwdriver for this. All you need to do is to unscrew all the bolts. This part just slides up. When you're putting this back together, make sure these little tabs here slot into the mesh. That's how it holds it together. Cool, now that we've taken that off, we have access to all the internals here. Step five. Now we're going to take off the main metal housing of the pump. To do this, you're going to need a 13mm spanner, and all you need to do is take off these four bolts here. And now that we've done that, we have complete access to the screw. Step six. Next, we need to remove the grub screws from this screw so that we can use them in the other screw. For this, you'll need a 3mm Allen key, and all you need to do is unscrew in these holes here and here. Step seven. The next step's a little tricky. You're gonna need a 14mm spanner for this. Essentially, we need to hold the motor shaft still while we twist this off. There should be some flat parts on this shaft here that you can feel. If you can't feel them, just spin them around until you can. It's underneath the rubber here. Now, we don't need to take this off, but we need to make sure we don't damage it. Essentially, just slide it in. There we go. And then you can unscrew. Remember me, this is actually the opposite thread so that it self-tightens when it's running. There we go. Screw off. Step eight. Now that we've taken that off, we can put the new one on. Don't forget to use your 14mm spanner to hold on to the motor shaft. And remember, it is opposite thread. You want to do this up quite tight. Because if you accidentally do the run the motor backwards, it can undo the screw, and then you'll have to take it apart again and put it back together again. Make sure the screw itself is tight, they're both threaded in.
Step 9.
And now you can put these back in. Right. Now that we've done those, we're going to put the whole thing back together.
Step 10.
Now we're going to put the main metal housing back on. Don't forget all the bolts and their spring washers. And just make sure to tighten these back up again. This is the 13 mil spanner. Don't go overly tight. Again, a lot of this is stainless steel.
Step 11.
And now we're going to put the cable shield back on and the grate. So you want to put the grate on first. Just hold it in place there. Then you can grab this part with these tabs and slide them back in there. Slide it down. Oh, stayed together. Now we can put this one back on. All you need to do is slot it in there. It's a bit tight, you want to undo these screws again. The key is you really do not want to damage the cable in any way. And then you can put this top part back on.
Step 12.
And finally, we want to put all the top stuff back on. So the pump housing of the screw, we're going to put that back in here. If this is a little hard to put on, it is worth lubricating. You can use cooking oil or a bit of dish soap. This just allows the screw to turn again. If it's left for a long period of time without lubrication, it can get stuck and it'll start spitting this housing in here. So now I've got that in. We're going to clamp it down using this. Try and put it back on the same way as before. Get your spring washers and bolts. Put them in all of these. Try to do this one up evenly. Just because it's clamping down on that housing. Ideally you want that to be relatively even. You can use your 10 mil socket to tighten these back up. And with that, you've replaced your screw. Now put it back in the water, test it, and make sure it's working as it should. If you need spare screws, or if you need any more information about the pump at all, please check out our website. A link to that is in the description below. But if you need any help along the way, have any tricky questions, please give us a call, send us an email. We're always happy to help.